session recording and the college2industry@gmail.com. Try to ask all your queries in the Telegram channel or the email ID. In case nobody is replying, then you can reach out to us using the WhatsApp. You all have my WhatsApp numbers. You all have the Sumit WhatsApp number. Take the relevant time. Relevant time means weekends, Saturday or Sunday. Okay, so we'll able to answer your queries. So college2industry@gmail.com, anytime you can reach out to this email ID. All recordings you all already have. Okay, go to your Telegram channel. There is a area link. Just click on that link. All recordings will be showing to you. Okay, so nobody will be saying in future that I don't have recording, where's the recording. Okay, so here this one, don't leave that Telegram channel because all those links are there. If you want to save those links in a separate text file, you can do that, whatever you want to do with that channel. Okay, so I will start GitHub session today. So first of all, what you have to do, you just need to go to this GitHub download. Okay, so you will see this desktop.github.com. just click on this. Okay, and you will see download for Windows 64-bit based on
your screen is not visible.
Okay, sorry. So now visible.
Yes.
So this is the URL, desktop.github.com. From here you can download the software, and it should be relevant to your system configuration. If you are using the 64-bit operating system, nowadays only 64-bit operating system are installed. Okay, so you will use in that way. Okay, so if you have 64, then just go for it. If you have other versions, then you can look here for those version, download and search from the URL. Okay, search on the GitHub. Simple is that. After downloading this, you will just install this software. Okay, installing, you all know how to install any software. Just double click next and install. At the time of installation, it will ask a email, username and password. Okay, give that username and password. Okay, from where that username and password will come, for that you have to create an account in github.com. I will go to the incognito window, github.com. okay, here you have to sign up. Okay, so this is the URL for sign up. Okay, once you going to sign up, at that time only it will ask enter your email. Look it here carefully, because once you will going to deploy your code, it will ask all the information first time only. Okay, until you configure your GitHub, you will not able to push your code in the GitHub account. Okay, so enter your email, continue, and here you simple go and continue. I don't know, maybe in incognito and window I am here, that's why I will go to another. Because I am already signed up, I will go with this one. Okay, So here you have to give your email ID, suppose ABC. Just get it loaded. Okay, suppose abc@gmail.com and then go continue. Okay, ABC is already taken. 1 2 3 4 5. Suppose I have another email ID, I am Vandan. Okay, then continue. And you have to create a password. Once you go give any password, then it will ask you for username. Okay, so similar way you will create account on GitHub, and after creating account you will note all your username and password. Even you can reset your username and password as well. So just like similar, you create account on Facebook, you create account on Gmail. Okay, so this is not a big deal, anyone can do that. Okay, now second thing is that after doing that you will install this software. First create the account, then install the software. Okay, now your GitHub is ready. Okay, so there is no worry, git will be ready. The second thing I will come, suppose this code you want to deploy, just go to this or test one, should have some code files at least. Okay, it has. Suppose this code I want to deploy, see the project name is test. Okay, this separate workspace has multiple projects. Like I go here, this is a workspace, and in this workspace you can see multiple projects are there. Similar way this one. Okay, so this has multiple projects which we have created for practice. So go inside this project where all files src level. Okay, at this level you have to go. Okay, I will delete this gitignore because previously may I use this one. Okay, so you have to go at this level. Okay, means inside the test folder your all projects files are there, you have to go at that level. So I am here. Okay, now what I will do, I will open my command prompt. I will close this, it is already open. I will open my command prompt cmd. Okay, so I open my command prompt. In your company you will use the git bash. Okay, in your company maybe you will be using git bash. This is similar to this command prompt. Okay, the things you can perform with the command prompt you cannot perform with the git bash, but whatever you can perform from the git bash you can perform from the command prompt. That's why I am using the command prompt, best way to do anything. Okay, here this gives us several facilities. You can launch this inside the project level like this. Okay, otherwise every command is same, everything is same. Like at this level you can see, and this will come by default, git bash will come by default after you install your software. Okay, that I have suggested you. Right click git bash here, and you can see it D selenium interview. At this point of level it already created for you. Okay, this you can also do with the command prompt. So this is similar to the command prompt, don't be came with any confusion for that. I am using command prompt, you will also try with the command prompt. If you want that, you want to go with the git bash, you can go. Similar commands are there, nothing, a single line is changes there. Okay, so this one. And why git bash? Because git bash will be supporting from the Linux also. Okay, but in Linux you will see multiple changes with the command prompt. That's why git bash is on practice, he's on picture. Okay, so there's nothing, anything else says you have to learn the GitHub, so you go with that. Okay, so I am here now. From the basic things that you need to know that we'll going through with, that you have to be in this level, Java Workspace D, and then Selenium R, Selenium interview preparation course, and then your test folder inside that will come. Okay, I will copy this one. And how I'll go? Normal class earth thing. First of all, D drive, and then CD, and then you paste your location. Okay, this level. After coming to this level, to close this one. Okay, you can see there is no Git related thing here. Okay, there is no Git related thing here. I'll come to that later. First of all, I will go to this URL, github.com. Anything in between you can ask. This is nothing complicated. Every time you are going to deploy your code, you should have a place where you are going to deploy. Okay, I am going to create that place only. Okay, so I am going to create that place. And how I'll do that? I will go to this plus icon, new repository. And here I will give June batch tutorial GitHub. I give this name, you give your project name. And create repository. Okay, so now at this URL you have to push your code, and whatever you are seeing just after login with the GitHub account, copy, and I will save URL here. So at this URL I want my code to be present. Now what I will do, now I will start Git things. I will place this here. You see at this level nothing is present from Git level. Okay, GitHub does not know what you have to copy and what you have to paste here. You will tell by command. And one more thing I want to let you know, there are multiple softwares. Multiple softwares are present in the market, even in Uptrend, that will allow you direct Git push, comparison, everything. But if you don't know the basics, if you don't know what is push command, what is pull command, what is commit, what is stash, what is add command, what is init command, then you will not able to know what's happening in the background. Tomorrow maybe that software is going to end. Okay, new software is coming, so you will be stuck. Okay, so best thing is to learn the basics and then go for the tools. Okay, so here what I'll do, first of all, there are more than 1 lakh accounts of the GitHub. Okay, how your GitHub will know in whatever present in your machine that you have to paste your code in that particular account? For that you have to know, you have to tell this command username and passwords, and these are the command for pasting the username and password. Password is not there, I will tell it where it come. Where is the chat box here? subscribers. One by one I will paste, you note it down. I will go to this one, git config. What we are going to configure? User.name. My username when I have created my account was sonuvandan123, and I will press enter. If something was wrong, then it was stopping me here out. Okay, git config user.email is equal to, when I have created my account, my email was Vandan Misra 686. Oh. Email, and then when I created my account, my email was Vandan Misra 6869@gmail.com. Sorry, and now this one. Once you will do this, listen to me carefully. Once you will do this first time, there will be pop-up coming. Check your all windows, like this one message, or it may be coming in the Internet Explorer, wherever it will be coming. You have to give the password. When you have created your account, you have given the password that I just told you few minutes back. Give that password here. If you forget, just reset it and then again paste it. This is a file. I will just share you how that screen will look like. When I was learning GitHub, maybe 5 or 6 years back, I have created these notes. Okay, and this helps me a lot every time. So whenever I am going to learn anything, what I do, I just create step by step notes for me, because every time I am not able to watch the videos of 30 or 40 minutes, okay, and for just 2-3 minute notes. Okay, so what I do, I create my quick notes, and then whenever I forget anything, I quickly access that. So whenever you are going to give username and password, username and email, screen will be coming like this. Okay, this pop-up screen will be coming. It will not appear in your window pop-up. It will just trigger something, and you have to find where, either the email, either the your Internet Explorer, either the Firefox, whatever your system settings are. Okay, so you have to go with that. Here you put your username and password. One time task. You don't have to do this again. Once you will give this one, already GitHub software is installed into your system. It will automatically trigger that username and password. You just need to go, even multiple times you don't need to give this username, email, everything. Okay, once for a particular project you connect it, it will. Password is once, username and email are every time when you are changing your project. Currently I'm working in test project. Tomorrow you are working in your different projects, so just configuring that system. This is it, nothing complicated. I'm making it complicated. Okay, so here this one is the file that I have to commit in my UR. Okay, now I will initialize this project from GitHub. So that is command git init. Once I enter here and go back to this URL, you can see git present here. Give me a second. okay, this is the URL, sorry, Git initialized. Okay, now GitHub is initialized. Now what you have to do, git add star, listen, oh my machine battery is not, okay, git add star. When you are going to commit your code first time, I am using wrong word because commit word is already there in the GitHub. So whenever you are going to add your files in your project, whatever you have to commit it first time, if you are going to do that, so all the files you have to commit, okay, all the files you have to commit, so what are you going to do? Git add star, it means you are going to add all files. Okay, if you have to change any single file, then git add and give the single file path, as simple as it is. I will share all the command details and you just try it once at least after this session. So git add star, okay, because I have to add all the files, I am using star. Even in SQL, if you are going through with the select star, means select all files, all the data, all the columns. Okay, add star. Okay, oh, all the files is added. Okay, now you want to check what files are added. Then if you want to check, this command is not necessary which I am going to write, but if you want to check what files are added, maybe you are adding a single file and after that you want to check that is added or not, so git status is the command and you can check the list of the files that are added. This is going in the local level only as of now. Okay, public level means GitHub URL level, if you are going to commit, then I will let you know. First just commit. At the local level all files are added. Okay, now this was the command git status, so I will here give first of all so that you can refer it later. Step by step commands, you note it down, it will better for you. Git init and git status, copy from your chat box, otherwise I will paste all these later also, better to do it as well. Okay, just copy this, I'm coming to. Now you have seen, okay, all the files are added. Now you have to commit for your local repository. And suppose from here you lost all your code, then if you have committed at local level, then you can get that code later. That is very far topic, at least you are not going to expert in a day. Okay, so you just commit git commit hyphen m and first, once you'll practice multiple times, then you are going to learn it. Okay, and you will have doubts also. This git, of course I am going to write a git command, I have to use this. Commit will commit at first level. There are two levels of commit, first at local level and second at public level. Public level does not mean everybody can access it, there will be some privacy settings also. So public level means that you are going to deploy your code in the hosting server. Hosting server means github.com or all. Okay, so git commit and this hyphen m, hyphen m means message, whatever you want to give message here. Suppose you want to remember your code process from the date and the time, because multiple times you can commit in a day. So suppose I am going to commit and give the name for 29/08/2021 and it is 9:58 hours. Okay, Okay, and suppose I am going to name that Vandan has committed all. Whatever message you will give. Okay. So. Okay. So these files have been committed. Whatever you can see here. Now you want to copy this code and you want to paste this code at server level or the public URL. Okay, so first of all, what is the URL that you need to tell? Okay, because without telling that, how it will know from this local repository where I have to post that code? So for that we have a command, git remote add origin, and you have to paste the origin here. This origin I have copied here. I will copy this origin and paste here. Now your question should come, how it will know that for this particular anybody can post this code here? No, because this is your repository, github.com/sonuvandan123. How you can access it? That you did in the first level. What you did, git remote, git add user.name, git add user.email, all the commands you have run already. First level, what you have to do, git config user.name, I said git add, sorry for that, git config user.email, everything you have given, and there will be a pop-up coming first time that I told you, password. Okay, so git config user.name, git config user. So you already told that where you have to post, but you, the next thing is that I am coming here. Yeah, now next thing is that how it will know it this URL? First of all, I will go, why I am going to add URL on? Because this is a project inside this repository, inside this server I have multiple codes, multiple softwares. So Selenium framework, Selenium WebDriver basic framework, collection, Selenium, these all are projects. So for which project I have to push my code, that I need to tell. So I will go to repository list, and here you can see, okay, June batch. Okay, so here in this level I want to post my code. Okay, so this URL I already copied. Okay, so you know that in a particular GitHub account you can post multiple projects. Okay, also I'll request you, if you want, then you can follow me on this account, because here multiple interview related things are there. I'll show you interview preparation, and here can see string logic programs, sticky questions, everything which is normally asked in interviews here. Okay, so I will give this URL. If you want to, so whatever URL I shown you, this interview preparation, okay, multiple things will be keep coming in this URL. Okay, so you just, and also I have keep a note here, I interview related course will be added here in future also. So based on the tomorrow, based on the company level, I'm going to provide these sessions. Okay, so this is the one, this I wanted to let you know. Okay, now this is remote that you want to push at github.com/sonuvandan123 batch tutorial, June batch tutorial. Okay, and enter. Now these all nodes where your code should be deployed. Next command is git push origin and the branch name. Currently I have only one branch, which is master. Okay, tomorrow your team lead will ask you to push your code in your branch. Suppose your name is Raman, then you will paste your code is Raman branch. So your git push origin and Raman, whatever your branch name, so you don't need to worry about that. Currently I have one branch only, which is the master. You can see counting objects 100%, okay, writing objects 100%. 68 objects were there and 68 objects were pushed also. This means all your code is pushed in the github.com, where you can see already it is telling that in this account. And which branch? New branch. Currently whenever you are going to deploy your code first time, there will be automatically a branch created, which will be master. Okay, so I'm going to 1 second. I am just coming with my charger. So what was the repository name? Okay, you can so see all your code is here. Whatever message I have given, you can see the 7 minutes back, and you can see 29082021958 time. Okay, so all your code is here. Suppose you have three developers are, or three automation test engineers are there, and they want your code. Because if I give an example, my team is working from the different location. Some people are working in the Canada location, some people are working in the America location. So everybody has not possible to work on same time, because my night shift will be here day shift, or their day shift will be have my night shift. So everybody wants to work in the day shift only. Okay, so companies are giving that much liability to you, that you want, can work in your time and so on. So what you need to do when you start your day, you need to take the latest code pushed by your correspondent developer which is working with you. Okay, so he worked in and you came after his work, and you first need to take the updated code. So here git status will do something. If he has pushed, you can see, git status, and you can see nothing to commit, work tree is clean. It means your code is updated. But if he commits something, then you need to run this command. Here the code will be shown, like here you will see the message that this file is updated or something. Will let it know, get it know. If you are going to type anything in this project, suppose I am going here, let me try if I am going to do it first time in this test. And then sanity, and then login page. Let me try. Not Java file. I'll open it text file. Maybe if here it works, then fine. Otherwise, we'll try it in our machine. Open with text file. suppose I just add one then comment line one then and then just case one and save it. Now just let me check if that works from here. Get status. Yeah, it happened. You can see changes staged for commit means your file is updated, and even it is telling you what's the file name is. So you can see src test java sanity login page. Okay, so you can see no changes added to commit. You just type the GitHub command. Previously the message was different, nothing to commit. Now your change this. Okay, so you can commit this code git commit hyphen m, and the second, suppose you are giving this message. Okay, git post origin and then master. Okay, you can see now everything is up to date, the message there. So similarly git status you will check when you going to start your day, and then if anything is changed then you will run this command git pull origin and correspondent developer name, sorry branch. Suppose his branch is master, his branch name may be anything, his name or any name. Okay, so suppose ABC, so you will type here git pull origin, and from which branch you want to push get that code, you just dig it. I want to from master. Okay, now my code is already up to date, that's why it's showing already up to date. Otherwise in your case it will be updated. Okay, so this is all about git.
Yeah,
so
one question I have, if I want to see the status of my branch only, what would be the command for that?
You want to see the status for your branch. Okay, of course.
Branch, yeah.
Okay, that's a good question. First of all, whatever branch you are working, okay, suppose currently I am in master branch, I am working in master branch, you will give this git branch minus b. Okay, so you will be switching to this branch. Okay, branch name. Okay, so whatever branch you are working in, so you will get the status of that branch only. Currently I have not setted anything, that's why I am by default I am in which branch, I am in master branch. So this status was for the master branch. Whenever you are working in any branch, then your status will be according to your branch, whatever branch you are working. Okay, so all that files I will be giving to you, all that code or whatever branch, how to switch the branch out, that you need to practice. You don't need to think about those much labels, but of course you need to know about these things. Suppose something went wrong just because of your corresponding developer did something wrong and you are not responsible for that, there you will run this git log command, or what last push you anybody did, everything will be here, enter. So you can see author sonu vandan 123, email id this, Sunday 29 August 9:59 AM he pushed his code. So multiple people, and which branch I have pushed my code, in master branch. Okay, so everything will be told here. Suppose you are responsible for your branch and you push by default in master branch, although there will be settings, there will be security settings done by the your tech architect or something, so you will not able to push your code in master branch, only he will be able to do that. But still you need to know that you need to push in your branch and you can see the logs that who has pushed code and which branch, who pushed latest one, who has not pushed your branch. Because normally when we start our end our date, then the team lead asks that all you need to know do is that you need to push your code. So some people don't push their codes, so here he can know that who did not post. So git log is there. Okay, so for further things like other tutorials, you have this URL. Where is gone? Yeah, this one. I'll copy this and paste it here. And also here. Now you can see this git init. I told you create a new local repository and then check out a please mute yourself. Now you can see git add star. I told you git commit, then git commit minus a. Okay, so if you want to push anything back, then you can check this git push origin master to push your code in master branch, git status, git remote, add origin, origin means server where you want to push your code, then git checkout branch name. So here you can check out the branch. Suppose you have I currently have only one branch. See I currently have only one branch, which is master. Okay, so if you want to list all the branches, means which are the branches, git branch, you can see it returns me masters only one branch is there. Okay, so if you have multiple branches, then it will list out your all branch. If you want to change your branch from branch A to branch B, then git checkout and the branch name. And okay, so suppose there is a branch master 2, so you want to check out to master B, so git checkout and master 2. And when you, now if you will get the status, get a status, it will be for master 2. Okay, similarly all these commands are there, but the necessary command I told you, git pull. Suppose you want to merge two different branches, then this is there, but this is will not be your task at initial level because there will be merge conflicts, learned by experience. Okay, so these all are commands that you need to go if you want to explore more. Otherwise whatever I told you is the sufficient amount that I told you. Okay, so anybody has any question related to this?
Can you tell me this pull, you know, I will get confused with pull command. If we pull, so the if I want to pull my code only, so how we will do that? Or
you want to pull only your code?
Yeah,
of course. You will be in your branch only. See, if you want to pull all your code only, so you don't need to do anything at your local repository, all your code is there. But if you something somehow if you are missed your code, okay, so what you need to do, you need to connect with your repository that initially I connected, and then you need to just run that command git pull origin and your branch name. So all that code will be coming from your branch only. Okay,